seeing how many Morgan Wallen song titles I can sneak into my sportscast.
But before we talk all things Tigers and Yellow Jackets, a big decision was made this week in college football with the Board of Managers unanimously voting to expand the college football playoffs to 12 teams in 2026. The sports commissioners are still trying to have it implemented sooner in 2024. So the way it'll work is the four highest ranked conference champions will be seeded 1 through 4 and receive a first round bye. Teams seeded 5 through 12 will play each other in the first round. Now, whether you're for or against this, this is still going down as a historic day in college football, and Dabo Swinney is ready for the challenge whenever it does happen.
Bring it on, let's go. You know, just tell us what the rules are. And I think we all knew this was coming, so.
The Tigers did arrive in Atlanta this evening ahead of kickoff. They got to check out Mercedes-Benz Stadium, and this time tomorrow, they'll be living the dream, taking the field against Georgia Tech. If you're heading that way, I talk more matchups tonight at 10 and 11. If yesterday is any indication of what's to come, this bar is incredibly high because we saw one of the craziest fourth quarters in college football history in a game that was up, down, had numerous lead changes. App State proved they're a dangerous offense. They scored 40 points in the fourth quarter, but where they came up short was on defense. More specifically, one thing they're not good at, not stopping opponents on third down. UNC converted on 9 of 14 third down attempts, so that's an area the Mountaineers say they'll address immediately this week.
It was a shootout between both teams, and we just needed to tighten up. And
for those that have shifted their focus to football and football only, I get it. This might be wasted on you, but I thought you should know this is the final home game of the 2020 baseball season for the Asheville Tourists, and you still have time to get down there. It's 1-0 Hot Rods in the first inning. And in Atlanta, the Braves had a 2-0 lead in the fifth when the tarp was rolled out due to heavy rain and a storm warning. But for the Braves, that didn't mean it was quitting time, nor were they going to hold up, because all that waiting was going to be somebody's problem, and unfortunately, they made it Andrew Nardi. Atlanta scores 3 against him when play resumes. They currently lead 7-1.